lived a handsome prince with a gloomy face, for he did not have a bride. Oh, he sighed, alas, and he pined, alas, but alas, the prince couldn't find a lass who would suit his mother's bride. For a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant way. But a genuine princess is exceedingly rare. On a stormy night, through the castle door, came the lass the prince had been waiting for. I'm a princess lost, quoth she. But the queen was cool and remained aloof, and she said, perhaps, but we'll need some proof. I'll prepare a test and see. I will test you thus, the old queen said. I'll put 20 downy mattresses upon her bed, and beneath those 20 mattresses I'll place one tiny pea. If that pea disturbs her slumber, then a true princess she. Now the bed was soft and extremely tall, but the dainty lass didn't sleep at all, and she told them so next day. Said the queen, my dear, if you felt that pee, then we've proof enough of your royalty. Let the wedding music play. And the people shouted quietly, hooray! For a princess is a delicate thing, delicate and dainty as a dragonfly's wing. You can recognize a lady by her elegant air. But a genuine princess is exceedingly
versions to this story, and I sing them all. This one, it's the prettiest, but it's not quite accurate. I happen to know the true story of the princess and the pea for the very good reason I was there. It was a small kingdom, ruled over by a talkative old queen and a mute king. Now, the princess in the true story was not the only girl to be tested. Actually, she was one of 13 girls. Girls who came to the castle hoping to wed the prince, but who, for one reason or another, were found to be unsuitable. As a matter of fact, the day I arrived at court, they were testing princess number 12. And a very, very curious quiz was in progress. Correct! Quiet! Are you ready for your next question?
I guess so.
Your next question concerns famous rulers. Are you quite ready?
Uh-huh.
Well then, name three kings. Is that clear?
Yes. Would you repeat the question, please?
Certainly. Name three kings.
May I take the third king first?
Yes.
Well then, three kings are...
Is this a trial?
No, it's a royalty test to find out if she's a real princess.
Oh.
King John, King Arthur, and...
Does it matter if she's a true princess?
Oh yes, if she's a true princess, we can all get married.
King Ethelred.
That is
absolutely correct.
Oh, Mama, she's smart. She's the best one yet, Mama. Can I marry her now, huh? Can I?
No, darling. There's still one question left.
Oh, this test isn't going to be fair.
It's the law that isn't fair.
Law?
The marriage law. Throughout the land, no one may wed till dauntless to the altars led.
Dauntless?
The prince.
Until he gets married?
None of us can!
You have now reached the Southern Plateau. And your final question is divided into four parts and concerns a famous man often referred to as the Knight of the Red Cross. One, what was his name? Two, what beast did he slay? Three, how many rows of teeth did the beast have and what kind? And four, what was the middle name of the daughter-in-law, the best friend of the blacksmith that forged the sword that killed the beast?
One, St. George. Two, the dragon. Three, 12 rows of teeth, and they were iron. And four, would you repeat the last question, please?
What was the middle name of the daughter-in-law of the best friend of the blacksmith that forged the sword that killed the beast?
The middle name?
The middle name.
The daughter-in-law?
In-law? You have 30 seconds.
Oh, pass, please, please pass.
You speak, my lady.
No, I...
20 seconds?
No.
She's a pretty little thing. I wish her success.
10 seconds?
No.
Oh, your time is expired. We must have your final answer, please.
Laura Lee?
And the correct answer is... Laura Lie. Yes, absolutely. The correct answer we were looking for is Laura Lie. I'm terribly sorry.
Oh, bad, my dear, too bad. Now you do show us that aptitude. As for the true brilliance of royalty, well, I'm afraid not. Remember, blood will tell, and yours didn't tell us quite enough. But here's a lovely consolation prize for you. Goodbye, good luck, get out! Now, don't dilly-dally, Dauntless. It's time for your cocoa.
Oh, I liked her.
So did I.
Why must every princess get the first?
It's just absurd.
I never heard a test so difficult to pass.
Alas, alas, is what I lack, alas, alas, alack.
Throughout the land, no one may win, so long the shares is very spent.
Oh, the lonely spinster's life goes. And get the prince a royal wife.
We have an opening for a princess, for a genuine certified princess.
Tell us when you intend to end this dilemma we're in.
None of the ladies give a fig for living in sin. We have an opening for a princess, for a beautiful, bona fide princess.
Where's the dutiful knight to right all the wrong we've been done?
None of the ladies are having any fun.
What to do?
What to do?
What to do?
What to do?
Pity the ladies in waiting.
Pity the gentlemen too.
4, 6, 8, 10, 11, 12
contenders in a row. They came, they were tested.
Then swiftly requested to go.
And get the prince a royal wife.
None of the ladies are having any.
No one is having any. No one is.
right.
That's my answer, wizard.
Splendid, splendid. Now watch closely. I take a perfectly plain piece of parchment with no cuts, folds, creases, or concealed pocket. Where? What is it?
Excuse me, Cardamon, but I have to take the minstrel to sign in at the castle steward.
This way, please.
I'm on my way to Normandy. I won't be staying long.
Yes, Chester. For your father's sake, I've gone along with your little performance thus far. But don't address me as Cardamon in this court. Just because your father and I were in show business together, well, don't push it.
Oh, Sir Harry!
Sir Harry! Oh. Missed the test.
Sweet Larkin, my new responsibilities as chivalric knight of the Harrow keep me busy.
Well, Lady's princess was a failure.
No.
Yes.
Bad luck. But don't despair, for we have plenty of time. If a true princess is not found in the next few months, I shall go out and find one myself. Or I don't know to wear my spurs.
Darling.
My love.
Do you remember the royal joust on Sunday when you won the spurs?
Of course.
You were named Sir Harry, the fairest and bravest knight in all the land, and everyone agreed that you had a brilliant future ahead of you. That you might someday become Lord Chamberlain, or even Prime Minister.
Well, I don't know about Prime Minister.
Do you remember the picnic we all had later on the greensward with the lovely cold pheasant?
Yes.
And you and I wandered away from the others to climb the hill and watch the sun go down.
Yes.
The lark was singing in the trees. You remember that moment forever because the lark song reminded you of my name.
Yes, Larkin, yes.
You and I watched the sun go down.
Yes.
Well, I'm gonna have a baby. Which is why Princess Fidontis must be found. And soon. I should have to go away somewhere. Oh, Harry, I'm so worried. It could ruin you. You'd never become Prime Minister or anything. Say the word, Harry, and I'll go now. I'll go far away, where they'll never find me. Say the word.
No. You'll stay here. Why should Clotheroe suffer all our lives just because you had a moment of weakness?
Oh, Harry!
Though none of us perfect, everything's going to be all right.
Thank you, Harry.
It won't be long, it won't, because it can't be long before our dreams come true. Because you know I don't belong, and furthermore I shan't belong to anyone but you.
Time is at a premium, for soon the world will see me. I'm a child.